To change what our box plots look like, we just need to adjust the y-axis. We can use the y-lim parameter inside of qplot to do so. Here I can set the upper and lower limits. The lower limit will be 0 and the upper limit will be 1,000. Now, you may or may not have gotten a warning message here about removing data points. When we use the y-lim parameter, we're actually removing data points from our calculations. So the original box plots that we have might look slightly different from this. Another way to create the same plot is to use the scale y continuous layer. So we can use the same bit of code here and then just close off our parentheses. Adding the scale y continuous layer, I can set the limits to be between 0 and 1,000. Running this code, we can see that we get the same exact box plots. What I want to draw your attention to is the female box plot. Notice how the top of the box is just below 250. So this value might be around 200 or 230. But this value might not be accurate for all of our data. When we use the y-lim parameter or the scale y continuous layer, we actually remove data points from calculations. So a better way to do this is to use the chord Cartesian layer to set the y limits instead. So we'll use the same bit of code, and then instead of adding scale y continuous layer, we'll add the chord Cartesian layer. And here I'll set the y limits from 0 to 1,000. Notice how the top of the box has moved slightly closer to 250 for females. I'll explain this difference in more detail in the next video. We'll also discuss what the top of the box means, what the bottom of the box means, and what this black line means.